Hi, I need a bunch of parts for my 3D printer build. So in this video, I will walk you through the setup and the machining for small-scale batch production run on my DIY CNC. The parts that I need are brackets that hold together aluminum extrusion pieces. Usually in my builds I use these right angle cast pieces, but since I'm machining all of the parts for the 3D printer, they don't really fit aesthetically and also they do lack some functionality. This is for example that due to the way they're manufactured, they're only precise in the 190 degree corner and they do leave quite a bit of play in the other axes. Tightening them can be difficult as the corners can be cramped, and as mentioned, they don't really fit the aesthetics of the rest of the build. This is then a perfect excuse for me to design and machine my own, and since I will need a bunch of parts, I can try my hands on setting up a small-scale production run. My idea is that I will use brackets that fix the extrusions from the outside rather than from within the corner. I think both approaches have their pros and cons, but for my build, this will work just fine. When designing the brackets, I have a couple of goals in mind. This would be improve the functionality by, for example, including alignment tabs and making the screws mount flush to the surface. I want to match the aesthetics of the rest of the build and also try to design something that can be manufactured quite easily or at least as possible to be machined in a batch production. I ended up designing two style of clamps, one for a single corner and the other one for a T-style junction. These are some prototypes that I machined to check some alignment features and also the tolerances. The brackets itself are 3 mm thick and the alignment tab is another 1.5 mm and 6 mm wide, so exactly the dimension of a normal aluminum extrusion. The alignment tabs are there to ensure that the brackets fit precisely. This allows me to use just one screw while maintaining also a secure grip to the aluminum profile. These dimensions let me use 5 mm aluminum plate, which I have plenty of in stock right now. And these screws are countersunk, enabling a more flush appearance. For me, the key difference between machining one-off parts, which I've been mostly doing so far, and now aiming for a small batch production, is reducing the setup changes and the manual work as much as possible. What this means then for machining multiples of a part, it can be more useful to spend some extra time and money in the beginning on a good work holding, some optimized tool paths, and an overall workflow. Therefore, my goals are to have a work holding setup where I can machine both sides of the part and be able to group machining operations that use the same tool. This is especially important for me as I don't have an automatic tool changer, and changing tools is one of the more time-consuming tasks when machining a part. this is the plan. I now put some test pieces in here to mock up how the raw stock and partially machined stock will sit in the fixture, and also put in the hex nuts from the Mighty Bytes. This is how I want to hold on to the part. I may need to increase the stock size a bit because I don't know if I will have enough clamping on these two sides. But it looks like it should work. This means that I can remove the fixture now from the T-slot table to drill out the holes and prepare the threads for the Mighty Bytes. So I think that worked out okay. This is the first time that I'm using these Mighty Byte low profile fixture clamps. I actually bought them for this project, so there are a couple learnings that I can already take away. One is that I sort of misjudged the length of the bolt. I was sure it was 10 mil, but I think it's maybe more, or I didn't account for the detent that I placed them in, so they do stick out the bottom. Second learning is that taking parts directly off the bandsaw and wanting to hold them with these kind of clamps is challenging, as you don't have a lot of travel. This means that I will probably increase my stock dimensions, as I already placed these screws a bit farther off, but this is not a big deal, I can just increase it. And third learning is that I haven't accounted for the bolts sticking out of the top. So the bolt is slightly higher than the hex clamp, even though the screw is as far into the material as possible. So these three things I didn't really know or didn't account for when designing or planning this, because it's the first time that I use these sort of clamps. But I think I can work around them. My idea with this fixturing is that it lets me machine both style of brackets with the same fixturing. This means the right angle one as well as the T-style clamp. Both start on the left side, the A side, with the cut blank and a single surfacing operation. After this, I can machine on each clamping position A and B, one part on either side. The first step, the surfacing, is quite a short operation and is done on one blank, one after each other. Next is the adaptive and contour work. This is done with a smaller end mill, and after the first part, I can flip the just machined one from the A side over to the B side and then continue machining on the A and B side. With this, the longest machining operation is done, and right after I can begin the cleanup by chamfering all edges. The final step is then spot drilling only on the B side for drilling and countersinking manually after the CNC machine. These tips are way better suited for my drill press and are done quite quickly at the end. It took quite some time to get the process in the right order where I can machine both the A and the B side. And while that optimized the tool paths and to make sure that I don't hit any alignment features or clamps. There is also not really a lot of material to hold onto. If I would just machine a couple, I would just probably glue the parts to a flat surface. But this is not really viable for doing multiple pieces, let's say more than 20. A vacuum chair could be a good option. Sadly, I don't have the capabilities right now, but this could be something for the future. I ended up needing to make some clearance adjustments to the fixture. For example, I had to file down some of the bolts so they don't stick out. And I also had to relieve some of the fixturing by running the G-code without any stock to him and remove some extra material. But for now, the process should be quite refined, and I can start my first production run with some T-style clamps and time the whole process. Thank you. Okay, first production run. The machine didn't crash and I didn't break any tools, so I think it was a success. It did take a bit longer than I originally thought. It was more than 10 minutes per bracket from cut piece to finished machined one, but I already see some improvements. This could be, for example, reducing the spring pass when doing the contour work, and also not taking a video while doing it probably helps. There was one flaw in my workflow. I noticed that I wouldn't be able to do the chamfering on the A side after I flipped the part. That meant that I ended up alternating between changing parts and changing tools, and maybe this is even better in the end. There were a bit of movement, I believe, in one of the fixtures. You can see this part sort of has an angle on this face, and I can't rotate it. So there's probably a misalignment between the A side and the B side, but as it's only with this part and the other ones do fit quite nice, I think this is not a general issue, but just one with this part. I think the parts are not great. There's possibilities to improving the surface finish, and I will fine-tune some dimensions, but this is with every aluminum extrusion, they're a bit different, so I will continue improving them to the ones that I have right now.
Over the next couple of runs, I was able to make some improvements. For example, I got rid of the extra planing operation and just used a smaller end mill for it. I was able to make some further toolpath optimizations and also just gotten more into the groove of the overall workflow. I did go through a couple of fixture clamps and one or two end mills, as I did not leave enough space and things sometimes collided. So it's far from perfect, but it also works quite well. I did increase the locating depth dimension to something like 6.2 or 6.4 millimeter, and now, depending on the type of extrusion, it's a nice and snug fit.
As always, I will put the files on the GitHub, but if you like these sort of projects and would like to have one of these brackets to yourself, I will put up a little shop where you can support my work. With these parts, I can continue with build and start assembling the Z-axis of my 3D printer. The process took quite some effort to refine, but I learned a lot about work holding and also optimizing tool paths. Maybe in the future I will explore something like vacuum work holding or other fixturing improvements. See you in the next one.